the principal secretary in the State Department of ICT in charge of innovation, and that is Jerome Ochieng. Many thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
And Jerome, let's just begin by taking stock of where we are as a country in the ICT space. We've been seeing other countries making significant leaps in terms of ICT penetration. Where are we as a country?
Thank you very much. In terms of ICT as a country, I would want to say that we've really made significant progress, bearing in mind that we are actually looked upon as one of the people who have really made tremendous progress in terms of mobile money transfer. This is something that is spoken about all over the world. So in terms of, I mean, looking at that just as an initiative, basically we are doing very well. Having said that, there's other elements that we may look at and consider ourselves having done very well. For example, on the development of the ICT infrastructure within the country, we have fiber backbone running across all the 47 counties that the national government has developed.
Yes.
And then we also have ICT-related applications. This is one of the few countries whereby people apply for their passports online and actually are able to do a lot of transactions online. When it comes to issues like financial management, we have the IFMIS, for example. And this is the financial management system that is used across the country, and a single system that runs throughout the whole country, whereby we're able to see a lot of visibility in terms of financial transactions. So beginning from the infrastructure side, we've done very well, that there are proper ICT infrastructure completely developed. Looking at the user side, we are talking about citizens being familiar with M-Pesa, mobile money transfer, and even the e-citizen platform, whereby they're able to use this infrastructure for their services. So basically, I would say we are among the leading, especially in Africa.
All right. Yeah. Quite a glamorous approach you've given us there, PS. But let's talk about the policy perspectives in the country. Right now, majority of the young people are very engaged when it comes to innovation, especially when you look at incubation centers that are mostly privately run. And this is a space that the government can also play in. And from where you sit, what are some of the key policies that you are considering, especially in terms of nurturing innovation and making sure that young person trying to come up with an interesting application makes it to the global stage?
Excellent. Very good. One of the things that we are currently doing, we have come up with a concept called, we are developing a white box. Basically, we are setting up a place whereby we will be encouraging startups to actually present their innovation. What is currently happening, and this is what led us to beginning the concept of the white box, is that somebody comes up with an innovation, either comes to see me or comes to see the CS, but this is only one person. But then through the white box, we are basically saying that every other entity or every other person with an innovation will be presenting their innovation somewhere. Then every member of the public is able to come and see. Some of them will help them, nurture them, develop them, and actually even take over the innovation through their various levels of agreement.
All right.
Other than that, we're also working very closely with the academia. We are working closely with the universities in terms of trying to nurture innovations. So basically, we are saying there's a lot of effort towards nurturing innovation and actually helping people, especially the startups, to nurture and develop their respective innovations.
All right. And still staying with this white box, it is clear that Kenya is ahead of other countries, especially in East Africa when it comes to innovation. But on the flip side, we are not seeing sufficient funding over and above young people being creative and trying to come up with solutions that can be used in the enterprise world.
Well, I think one of the things and the few discussion I've had with the young people is their fear to bring out their innovation through people, and then their intellectual property is not protected.
Mm-hmm.
So I've seen, and I think that seems to be a very big area that we really need to work on. People tend to hold on to their innovation for fear, but then we are coming up with the policies to actually protect the innovators, and actually they take ownership, and in case there is reward for that, then they are fully rewarded. So that will encourage the people to come out themselves and actually participate in innovation. I know there's a lot of things that are happening, but one of the things, the few I've had conversation with, they're always afraid that this is my idea, but immediately I bring it out there,
mm-hmm.
somebody picks it and runs away with it,
okay.
ending up benefiting. So that has kind of tended to make people hold on to their innovations. But we're coming up with policies that will encourage them,
mm-hmm.
and actually ensure that the intellectual property is fully protected, and actually they are given an opportunity to and they are compensated.
Okay.
Yeah.
And PS, as we wrap up, mm-hmm. one of the other aspects, of course, that touches on ICT is bringing stakeholders together to discuss where, mm-hmm. what next, and the way forward, especially from a policy standpoint. And all this is usually achieved through the Connected Kenya Summit,
mm-hmm.
which is organized by the ICT Authority. And what should you expect this year, mm-hmm. where we're seeing the government is running the Big Four agenda,
mm-hmm.
how can people tap in into this as they try to shepherd conversations in mm-hmm. terms of growing the ICT landscape?
Mm-hmm. Well, this year's Connected Kenya is running from 22nd to 24th. The most interesting thing about this year's Connected Kenya is that we will be having it at the Bomas of Kenya. And the theme for this year's Connected is preserving our heritage. It's for that reason that we actually looked at and used the Bomas of Kenya for the purposes of the cultural aspect of it. You realize that really we are losing a lot of this culture, and unfortunately most of our culture from the African perspective is really never documented.
Mm-hmm.
We want to create an opportunity whereby we document our culture. But then coming to the Big Four agenda, which is basically the most important thing currently as government, we are focusing on how can technology help us leapfrog and achieve the Big Four agenda in the shortest time possible. So we are looking at people coming up with ideas in terms of areas of manufacturing. And as government, we have also started on the areas of manufacturing. I've been running around trying to see how do we do local assembly for our own computers, for example.
Yeah.
And that is a program we have already started.
All right.
On the area of health, in terms of provision of universal health, technology can actually help us attain universal health in the shortest time possible by coming up with health information systems. Information relating to health are computerized, digitized, and data is captured. Doctors are able to share information among themselves. That one is an area we're already working on. Now, when it comes to the issues of housing, then we using, for example, blockchain technology, which is also something that is actually going to be discussed, we can actually help the housing sector to ensure that there is fair and equal distribution for these particular houses, because this is one of the areas that is normally very contentious when people are asking, how will you distribute these houses? How do we know that we are actually not giving the same person the number of houses that have been developed, constructed through this initiative?
All right.
So we are saying blockchain technology is going to provide us a solution, and we'll come up even with algorithms that will help us ensure we fairly distribute the houses to the needy people. Then food security technology plays a very important role. Why we're even saying we're going to have our exhibition at the Bomas of Kenya is that we have enough space that we can even fly drones to actually show that we can mechanize and automate our agriculture, whereby now we move from what we would call the traditional guesswork agriculture to precision agriculture. So that we are saying you have a device that actually, if it is irrigation, puts water where it is exactly needed. So technology, ICT plays a very important role in providing and ensuring that we achieve the Big Four agenda.
All right.
In the shortest time possible.
Thank you.
Because it is cross-cutting.
Indeed.
Mm-hmm.
Quite interesting. Looking mm-hmm. forward to the Connected Kenya Summit.
Karibu sana.
Many thanks, PS.
Thank you very much.
Wish you all the best. And
see you at Connected.
Of course, there's a lot more to discuss, and we should be definitely inviting you over for more conversations.
Most welcome.
Well, that is the Principal Secretary in charge of ICT, Jerome Ochieng, just trying to give us an overview of these sectors' performance.